up, guys? AB Trades here with a little breakdown on US 30, right? So it's been a few days since I did one of these. So currently it is June 5th. So you guys see up there, June 5th, 5 p.m. So literally this is going to be my breakdown for the remaining of this week, right? So I traded US 30 this morning. Beautiful trade, by the way. I'll show it to you guys now. But looking at this higher time frame, such as the 4 hour, right? Price has reached a major area of resistance, right? As you guys see, price has reached this zone multiple times. So has it reached this zone as well over here, right? Now, price still could be on a downtrend, right? Just because we did this massive push to the upside doesn't mean structure has changed in a way. Yes, it has changed temporarily, but overall though, it is still in a bearish market due to the fact that we still haven't broken the most pivotal point in the structure, basically, which is up here. Now, once this is broken, yes, 100% fully biased, it's just straight bullish, you know what I mean? But as of right now, both scenarios are still on the table. Yes, price could still be bullish. You know, this minus structure that has been forming here in this 4 hour time frame could hold on, you know, find support somewhere around here, probably this support area around 33,466. So it could find support around there and then keep pushing its way back up, but it could also reject from here and then majorly drop from that point on, and you know the rest. But yeah, so this morning, right? So let me go on the smaller time frame, such as the hourly. So this morning, right? So this was around 9 a.m., right? So I woke up and I see price starting to like reject that zone. So if I go on a smaller time frame, so you guys could really see it, such as like a 15 minute, let's say this was this morning straight. Nice 1, 2, 3 risk to reward. So if I go on this 15 minute time frame, right? I woke up and I see price is kind of, it rejected this major resistance, right? Then created a new lower high here. And then it was like within this little range over here, you could say. So literally, I literally just grabbed these lows from over here. That's why I trade from zones to zones, right? So I grabbed this little low over here. I dragged it to my right and I was like, you know what? Once price fully breaks below, then I am all for it for the sells, right? So I originally got in sales here. I'm not gonna lie, I originally got in sales here. There was news at 10 a.m. today. So literally I knew price, regardless of news or whatever, had to drop. So news took me out, this little wick, as you guys see right here. Now, what happens when that happens? So every time there's news and that happens, I always give my setups two opportunities. I mean, I do that regardless, whether there's news or no news, or it's just a regular trading days, I still give it two trading opportunities, right? So I give that setup two opportunities to play out. If it doesn't, then I come back the next day and try it all over again. But you know, I don't keep chasing the market the same day, because then I'll catch myself revenge trading, basically, in other words, right? So this wick right here took me out. I was like, you know what? No rush. Once I break back down below this support again, I will give it a second chance. And man, literally once price started rejecting, this all happened on a smaller time frame. So if I go on a smaller time frame, you guys will see it better. So you guys see it, look, on a 5 minute time frame, right? Candle push up here. I knew it was just a liquidity grab, you know what I mean? So once I saw price starting to push back down, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give my same trade another opportunity. Gave it another opportunity, and man, it was just beautiful after that. Literally perfect trade, right? So now moving forward, right? Moving forward to tomorrow morning. So I want to see where price is going to be in the morning, right? So price could either be at this area of support down here, which is 33,460, as I mentioned before. If it's around here and price rejects, let's say we're like a bullish engulfing candle from this area, then yes, I will give buys a chance all the way up to this resistance. But if price, you know, builds some type of downtrend structure and now we're starting to break below this support over here, then I will be giving sales an opportunity back down to 33,300, you could say, in other words, right? Why? Because price has to retrace, man. Like last week, we did a massive push to the upside. So last week was, there was news on Friday. It was unemployment rate or something like that. And literally, that's where we got this rally to the upside over here, which price has to correct that move. Even if it's coming back down to 33,300 level over here, and then from there keep going on forward, it doesn't matter. It still has to retrace this move, right? So something that you guys could use to see more or less where that retracement is going to go, it could be a Fibonacci, for example. See, I like using these type of stuff as confluences. I don't really go based on them to like tell me where price is going to go or any of that stuff. So as you guys see, I have a support coming in around 33,460. According to Fibonacci, the 0.382 level will be at 33,387, which is not that far off, about 70 points or so. But yeah, I'd rather have mine, which is a little bit more safe because it's right at the top of these highs, because what if price doesn't fully extend, right? So you can't, you can depend on Fibonacci's all the time. You know what I mean? You got to just use them as what they are, a confluence. You know what I mean? So definitely same scenario that I have playing out. I do want to see price kind of come down to this 33,300 level. So that would be a perfect 50% rejection on a Fibonacci, which that could push price back up, you know, towards the highs. But obviously, we're not going to target that far off rip. Probably for the remaining of this week, I'll be targeting probably to see, I don't know, price come down here or even down here. It doesn't matter. Any of these areas over here, I am comfortable with price coming down to. Now, if it comes down to over here, then obviously we are in, you know, this bearish trend still continuing and price will keep pushing downwards, right? But if we come back down at least to these highs over here or whatever, it doesn't matter. But let's just say for the case we come down to here, find support. I definitely first area of you know, target that I would like to see is these get taken out. Once this area gets broken, then obviously I will be targeting this zone and then ultimately, you know, these highs. But for the remaining of this week, which is 4 days now, four more trading days, I do want to see something like this play out, obviously, you know. So again, we keeping both scenarios in mind due to the fact that we are still dominantly in a bearish market. Yes, currently we have been forming somewhat of like an upward trend, but dominantly we are still in a bearish market. So I want to keep both scenarios in my head, both either buys or sells, doesn't matter. But like I explained, I do want to see something like this play out. If price does break below, you know, any of these areas, then yes, I will strictly only be looking for sells back down to either this area of consolidation again, or we'll be finally pushing down to the support of 32,500. So let's see what happens in the upcoming days. This is just a little breakdown for you guys. Want to break down today's trade and, you know, potential setups that could be happening throughout the entire week. So I hope you guys like this video. Please comment, subscribe, I don't know, repost, something. Just let me know you guys like these videos so I could keep doing them. I do want to grow my channel. One of my goals for this year, I don't want to push too crazy, but at least let's say 30,000 followers or 40,000 subs or so. You know what I mean? We're currently at like 2.5 or something like that. So we're just getting started. So if you guys like these type of videos, please let me know. I will be doing vlogs and all the other stuff as well. Just, you know, I want to do it the right way. So I want to set up everything differently. So I wear anything educational is in one side and anything vlog related or just lifestyle related is on another part of the page. So hope you guys like this video. Please give it a thumbs up, a like, a comment, something. See you guys in the next one.